cocooned in the fragile shell of the atmosphere, planet Earth rotates serenely on its axis, like a blue and white jewel. Home to as many as 100 million different species of living beings, it is the cradle of humanity. It is the only known planet to support life. But what are humans doing? Some have become like machines, running to win, to live a branded life, to achieve and conquer. Some, on the other hand, simply move without any focus in life. They are content with a hassle-free existence. If we could read their thoughts, surprisingly, we will only find them comparing themselves with someone who is faring better. Humans have become so robotic that their feelings, thinking, and lifestyle are caged inside their hectic life. They find no time to think about other life forms around them that add beauty to the earth, and without which, nature will be incomplete. Stop and take a moment to listen to the sound of silence. Welcome to the world of flora and fauna. A world of beauty and serenity. Feel the pleasant weather and the fresh air that lightens your heart. Observe the birds fly in their tender and gentle way. Ever seen the little squirrels at play? Trace the flight of the busy bees and butterflies. Drink in the warmth of the sun rays that seep through the foliage and brighten up the day. Flora and fauna are all around us. They are as much a reality as we are, even though many a time we fail to acknowledge them. Flora refers to the plant life of a region, and fauna, the animal life. Plants cover approximately 9.4% of the Earth's surface, which is 30% of the total land area. Forests are home to more than 45,000 floral species and 81,000 faunal species. India houses over 2,000 species of birds, 500 species of reptiles and amphibians, and over 30,000 species of insects, including butterflies. The wide range of climatic conditions gives India its rich variety of vegetation. The flora and fauna found in a particular place constitute its ecosystem, a biological community of interacting organisms and their physical environment. We are also part of this ecosystem. Ecosystems consist of various living beings that may vary in size from a few microns to several feet long, each contributing equally in maintaining the ecological balance. Some members of the ecosystem in which we live are Bush Morning Glory. It is a shrub which grows from 1 to 5 meters high. The plant blooms in clusters of 4-inch pink flowers all spring and summer long. Yellow Cosmos. The plant varies in height from 1 to 7 feet. The original and its cultivars appear in shades of yellow, orange, and red. Vinca Rosea. The species has been long cultivated for herbal medicine and as an ornamental plant. In traditional Chinese medicine, extracts from it have been used to treat numerous diseases, including diabetes and malaria. Pink petunia, a species of petunia with a lax sprawling habit, spreading outward rather than upward. Flowers are only 2 inches wide, fragrant, violet-colored, and cover the plants all summer long. Flame of the forest. It is a species of bhuti, native to tropical southern Asia, from Pakistan, India, Bangladesh, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Myanmar, Thailand, and Laos. Obscure Morning Glory. The seed of this plant is toxic if ingested. This plant is introduced to some part of the plant's floristic area. Tridax daisy. It is best known as a widespread weed and pest plant. It is native to the tropical Americas, but it has been introduced to tropical, subtropical, and mild temperate regions worldwide. Climbing acacia. The plants tend to be thorny and pod-bearing, with sap and leaves, typically bearing large amounts of tannins. Red lantana. It is an ornamental plant and is considered an invasive species in many tropical areas. Bottle brush. It is native to the states of New South Wales and Queensland in Australia, where it often occurs along watercourses. Balsam. Different parts of the plant are used to treat diseases and skin infections. Juice from balsam leaves treat warts and also snake bites, while the flower can be applied to burns to cool the skin. Oleander. It is native to a broad area from Morocco and Portugal, eastward through the Mediterranean region and southern Asia to Yunnan in southern parts of China. It typically occurs around dry stream beds. Pink lantana. The species will grow to 6 feet height and may spread to 8 feet in width, with some varieties able to clamber like vines to greater heights with support. China aster. It is native to China and is an annual plant growing from 20 to 80 centimeters tall with branched stems. It is a popular ornamental plant in gardens. Globe amaranth. Its native range is in Brazil, Panama, and Guatemala. The flowers are boiled to make tea, which is used for baby gripe, oliguria, cough, and diabetes. Yellow bells. It is found throughout much of neotropical Americas, including southwestern United States and Florida, Mexico, the Caribbean, the Bahamas, Central America, and South America as far south as northern Argentina. Golden trumpet vine. They have become naturalized through the tropics. They may be seen in roadside ditches, abandoned yards, and dumps. Pink vinca. It blooms beautifully from the first warm days of late spring to first frost in the fall. Violet petunia. The flowers are only 2 inches wide, fragrant, violet-colored, and cover the plants all summer long. It is a tough plant and has great heat tolerance for petunia. The Nilgiri wood pigeon is a large pigeon found in the moist deciduous forests and sholas of the Western Ghats in southwestern India. They are best identified in the field by their large size, dark colors, and distinctive checkerboard pattern on their nape. The crimson-backed sunbird is a sunbird endemic to the Western Ghats of India. Like other sunbirds, they feed mainly on the nectar, although they take insects especially to feed their young. They are tiny birds that are resident and found in forests, but are particularly attracted to gardens at the edge of the forest. The Nilgiri pipit bird is a species endemic to the Western Ghats in South India. It is closely associated with the short montane grasslands interspersed with marshy grounds and small streams, mostly in hill slopes above 1,500 meters of Tamil Nadu and Kerala. The rufous babbler is an old world babbler endemic to the Western Ghats of South India. It is dark brown and long-tailed and is usually seen foraging in noisy groups along open hillsides, grass or forests. The white-breasted kingfisher is a tree kingfisher, widely distributed in Eurasia from Bulgaria, Turkey, and through South Asia to the Philippines. It can often be found well away from water, where it feeds on a wide range of prey that includes small reptiles, amphibians, crabs, and small rodents. Ash-eared Rongo is found widely distributed across South and Southeast Asia. The ash-eared Rongo has short legs and sits very upright while perched prominently, often high on a tree. They are found singly, in pairs, or in small groups. Asian paradise flycatchers inhabit thick forests and well-wooded habitats from Turkestan to Manchuria, all over India and Sri Lanka, to the Malay archipelago on the islands of Sumba and Alor. They are migratory and spend the winter season in tropical Asia. Squirrels are indigenous to the Americas, Eurasia, and Africa, and have been introduced to Australia. Squirrels live in almost every habitat from tropical rainforest to semi-arid desert, avoiding only the high polar regions and the driest of deserts. The northern pearly eye is a species of Saturninae that occurs in North America. It habitats in damp deciduous forests, usually near the marshes or waterways, mixed or grassy woodlands. Tawny Costa butterfly is found in Sri Lanka and India, Thailand, and quite recently in Peninsular Malaysia. It inhabits the primary and secondary forests. Common lime personifies the butterfly's tolerance and adaptation to diverse habitats. It can be found in the savannas, fallow lands, gardens, evergreen and semi-evergreen forests, and shows a preference for streams and riverbeds. Asiatic honeybees are small honeybees of South and Southeastern Asia, such as China, India, Japan, Malaysia, Nepal, Bangladesh, and Papua New Guinea. In the wild, they prefer to nest in small spaces such as hollowed-out tree trunks. Trithemis annulata is a medium-sized species of African origins, which is reasonably common and widespread along the Mediterranean coast. Everything you see exists together in a delicate balance. We need to understand that balance and respect all creatures. We are all connected in the great circle of life, and Earth is our home. We nurture Earth, Earth protects us. Even if you don't protect it, at least don't destroy it.